Freehold High School senior class.
I think we can all say that 2020 started out great.
We won the Cunard Classic.
We placed in the state for wrestling.
67 of you went to DECA States, and 23 of you were qualified to compete at Nationals.
You had a successful Mr. FHS fundraising event.
And you were on your way to a BOTC championship.
This was the senior year you all imagined.
But no one knew
that when you left school on Friday, March 13th,
it would be the last time you heard my voice on the morning announcements.
It would be the last time you ate lunch in C106.
It would be the last time you need an ID to use the bathroom.
And it would be the last time that you walked through the halls of the borough.
It's okay to be sad, because so are we.
We wish we could give you the senior year you deserve.
And although we are trying to find other ways to celebrate your success,
we understand it is not the same.
We know that you missed out on all the milestone events.
But we also know that this is just one chapter in your book of life.
A book that will be filled with other memorable moments.
And instead of focusing on what you're missing,
think about everything you're gaining.
Time.
Family connection.
And an appreciation for the simple things in life.
In a world filled with so much uncertainty,
we are certain about one thing.
The class of 2020 rose to the occasion.
And for that, we are grateful.
You had the same routine for almost 13 years.
And in the blink of an eye,
everything changed.
You no longer needed to get up to an alarm
or raise your hand because you were thirsty.
There wasn't any more face-to-face instruction
or face-to-face communication at all.
Computer screen and sweatpants
became the new normal.
But as we expected, you adapted to this change
and made it work.
Because you are strong.
You are Borough Strong.
You continue to impress us on a daily basis.
With your motivation
and individual determination.
Some of you are working to support your families.
Some of you are at home taking care of your loved ones.
Some of you are role models to your siblings and peers.
And some of you may not even know which day of the week it is.
But it's okay, because neither do we.
The longer days give us all more time to reflect.
And as you look back on your last 4 years,
we hope that you realize
that there's a reason behind every role
and a method behind every thoughtfully planned out lesson.
It is no secret that we wanted to challenge you.
We wanted you to think outside of the box.
And we wanted you to do the things
you thought you never could.
But we also tried to teach you more than just the content in our classes.
We wanted to instill values, morals, and a sense of community.
And believe it or not, we were teenagers once.
We know you'll remember the frustrations as well.
We could apologize for every time we gave you too much work.
Every time we told you to get off your phone.
Or every time we called home.
But we aren't going to.
Because we aren't sorry we pushed you to do more.
Or stopped you from watching YouTube.
Or called home to make sure you were okay.
We didn't do it to annoy you.
We did it because we cared.
You were our number one priority.
And your well-being was, and still is,
at the core of every decision we make.
And although none of us could have anticipated our current situation,
we hope we prepared you with tools, knowledge, to overcome any obstacle ahead.
And as we, the teachers, look back on these past 4 years,
we realize how much we learned from you.
Whether it is the latest slang,
the newest trends,
or the power of hard work and resilience.
In times of defeat,
you never gave up.
And we are proud to call you our students.
Thank you for making us better teachers.
Thank you for making us better coaches.
And thank you for making us better leaders.
The class of 2020 will always hold a special place in our hearts.
And we will miss you more than you'll ever know.
And as you move on to the next chapter of your life,
wherever your journey may take you.
Continue to shine, to smile, and impress like you have the 4 years you've been at Freehold High School. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you a lifetime of love and peace.